From CBS News in Washington, Bob Schieffer.
Good morning again, and Senator McCain is in the studio with us. We begin with him. Senator, when the president decided to put out these memos outlining the interrogation methods the previous administration used, he apparently intended to put them out, say we'll never do it again, and thought that would be the end of it. It has been far from that. He has really opened a can of worms. You were among the first to condemn torture as a use for interrogators. You said it didn't work. It put our own people in jeopardy of having the enemy use it on them. You were very, very strong about that. But now you say we should not have an investigation into this, that we should move on. Why have you decided on that?
First of all, let me repeat what you just said, Bob. I have opposed torture. It's a violation of the Geneva Conventions. I worry about treatment of Americans in future conflicts. But a very brief story. Senator Lindsey Graham and I were at Camp Buka. 20,000 Iraqis were held prisoner there. We met with a former high-ranking member of Al-Qaeda. I said to him, I said, how did you succeed? What was the recipe for your success? He said two things. One, the chaos that existed after the initial invasion. There was no order whatsoever. He said, second, Abu Ghraib. He said, we were able to recruit thousands of young men into our cause because of Abu Ghraib. So have no doubt about my feeling about that. And we did pass the Detainee Treatment Act, which prohibits cruel, inhumane, and degrading treatment. But so we are where we are. There has been an investigation by the Senate Armed Services Committee. It is well known what happened. There is going to be pictures that are going to be coming out, which will again authenticate that wrong things are done. But are you going to prosecute people for giving bad legal advice? Are you going to keep on down this road in order, frankly, to maybe there's an element of settling old political scores here. We need to put this behind us. We need to move forward. We've made a commitment that we will never do this again. No administration, I believe, would ever do this again. And it's time to fight the wars that we're in. We're not done in Iraq by a long shot, and Afghanistan has very, very great difficulties. We need a united nation, not a divided one. Finally, you were around when President Ford pardoned President Nixon. There were allegations of criminal activity on the part of the President of the United States. Most people in retrospect believe that the Ford pardon was right because we moved on. We've got to move on.
I guess the people on the other side would say yes, but people are not going to believe we really mean that unless the people who did it are held accountable.
I think, one, they've been held accountable in the court of public opinion. Second of all, these people were giving legal advice, the ones we're talking about now. The president's already said CIA operatives. And by the way, morale over at the CIA is not at its highest right now, but the president said that he wouldn't have any prosecution of CIA operatives. So who are we looking at? We're looking at people that gave the advice. It was bad advice. But if you're going to criminalize bad advice by the part of lawyers, how are you going to get people to serve, and what kind of a precedent does that set for the future?
Let me ask you about this. Vice President Cheney says he wants more of these documents made public so the public will understand that these interrogation methods worked.
Well, as you know, the Vice President and I strongly disagreed on the fundamentals of this issue. But the Vice President of the United States has the right to weigh in on this discussion if he wants to. After all, it's the decision.
Do you agree with him?
No, I don't think it's necessary, to be honest with you. But if the Vice President feels it's necessary, then I think he's entitled. And when extreme talk show hosts say that he wants another attack on the United States, I think that's shameful.
Let me ask you about this. David Broder of the Washington Post said this morning in the Post that having vowed to end these things, President Obama should do all he can and use all the influence of his office to stop a retroactive search for scapegoats. Do you think Barack Obama should do more than he's already done?
Well, I wouldn't have released the memos because it obviously
put
some gasoline on the fire. I wish that the president, he's going to address the nation after the first 100 days here. I wish he would repeat it to the American people. I think the American people generally, once they have found out what happened and the and they know, are ready to move forward as well.
The Attorney General says he will not permit the criminalization of policy differences, which is you're saying that's right. But he said, if I see wrongdoing, and these are his words, I will pursue to the full extent of the law, pursue that to the full extent of the law. What does that mean?
And I don't know, because no one has alleged, quote, wrongdoing. They have alleged that this advice was wrong and that somehow that these people who gave this advice should be subject to criminal prosecution. I don't agree with that. Yeah. So I don't know what the Attorney General is talking about.
So you wouldn't favor even appointing a special prosecutor to look into it?
The allegations are that they gave the wrong counsel. That's and that bad things were done, and we violated fundamental commitments that the United States of America made when we signed the Geneva Conventions, and we disregarded what might happen to Americans who are held captive in the future. And by the way, those who say our enemies won't abide by the Geneva Conventions, they will if they know that there's going to be retribution for their violation of it.
I asked you about this quickly. Jay Barbee, who was one of the people at the Justice Department that wrote the memos that gave the CIA what they call the legal reasons to go ahead with all this, he's now a federal judge. We understand that he very much regrets, or at least he's told people he regrets having written those memos. Do you think that he should be impeached, or do you think that he should resign, or do you think he should be left alone?
Well, resignation would be a decision he would have to make on his own, but he falls into the same category as everybody else as far as giving very bad advice and misinterpreting fundamentally what the United States is all about, much less things like the Geneva Conventions. Under President Reagan, we signed an agreement against torture. We were in violation of that.
All right. Senator McCain, always a pleasure to have you with us.
Thanks for having me.
We'll be back in 1 minute to get some other views on this.